Hi, I'm Alan Morris, and in the next few minutes, we're going to take a look at what it means to be in the communications department at Big Spring High School. Welcome to the most fun that you will ever have working hard and learning some really neat stuff. In no particular order, here are some of the details in the communications classes. Everyone always wants to know, what are the supplies that I'm going to need for the class? What are they going to be? Well, let's quickly go over that. You're going to need something with which to write every single day. That's a pen or a pencil. You're going to need paper every single day. You're going to need a 32-gig USB flash drive, and if you don't understand that, come see me and I'll be glad to explain it. You're going to need a 16-gig SD card. Not a micro one, but a standard one. You're going to need a digital camera of some sorts. Your cell phone camera is probably going to be more than good enough. You're going to need a way to watch YouTube videos and to keep your device charged. You are welcome to bring your own laptop. We will be using downloadable software, Google Apps, and Microsoft Office Suite products. An acceptable use policy must be signed and on file for you to be able to earn credit in this class. The expectations in this class are that you already know how to use the keyboard, or in other words, how to type. Otherwise, this class will be a challenge. Additionally, it is expected that you desire to be treated like an adult and not a child. Therefore, it is expected that you will behave like a mature adult. Anyone wishing to be treated like a child needs to speak up so that accommodations can be made. Email. Almost all assignments will be given and turned in via your professional level Gmail account. For the class, you will need to set up and maintain a professional level Gmail account. A common problem is that students do not remember their passwords. If you already have a professional level Gmail account, then great, you're good to go. If, however, you have a cutesy one, that's not good enough for this class, and you will need to create a professional level Gmail account that you will be using for this class. If you do not understand, then simply ask. That's what you do when you don't understand something. Assignments. There will be at least two assignments each week. One will be a weekly report that is due after the last day of class for the week and before midnight on Friday of that same week. Most simply put, the subject line will be your first name and the period that you have the class. For example, in my case, it would be Alan Morris, first period, if I were in the first period class. Your weekly report will be graded pass-fail. It is to be well-written and explain what you have learned or accomplished for the week. Additionally, explain the obstacles that you have overcome or ask for help and explain exactly how you can be helped. The weekly report is a standing assignment. That means we'll have it every week. The second assignment will be emailed to you before the week starts. Normally, that's over the weekend, and its due dates will be given in the assignment. Sometimes your assignment will be simply to watch an online video and be ready for the quiz and class discussion over the video. Your very first assignment is to send an email from your professional level Gmail account to your instructor by this Friday at midnight. The address is colonel.allen.m.morris@gmail.com. Respect is the key word for this class. It is expected that you will respect yourself, you will respect others, you will respect the school, you will respect the equipment, you will respect deadlines, and respect those who are wanting to learn. Everybody wants to know about late work, so late work will be accepted without penalty when it is accompanied with documentation that you have performed 1 hour of community service per calendar day late. Yeah, you can get some in the bank if you want. A list of places that are acceptable for you to do your community service will be emailed to you when you send in your first email, or you may ask in writing if an institution is acceptable for your community service. Mowing the grass for the neighbor is not community service. Working for the school is. Helping a teacher is. All kinds of ways that you can do community service. Attendance. Attendance is taken by a sign-up sheet. You will write your name neatly and clearly on the class attendance sheet beside your printed name upon entering the class. You will not sign in for anyone else. Please, make no other marks on the sign-in sheet. I use it for a paper gradebook in class sometimes. When you are tardy, you will bring a tardy pass and sign in tardy too. There are many acceptable reasons to miss class. Communicate them with your instructor in advance or via email as much as possible. In other words, take care of your business. Leaving class. There are many good reasons to leave class too. When you must leave, you will write your own pass. Put on the pass your full name and the date and destination. Then get your instructor to sign it when you're not interrupting him. Take the colored hall pass with you too, because that's what administrators will be looking for. And upon returning, hand both passes to your instructor. Subs? Hey, we're going to have subs. There are reasons I'm going to miss. Subs, we will have a sub from time to time. We treat our subs like royalty, and we help them with things like attendance, showing videos, and normal procedures. So, do your best. This is a project-based class, and projects are not graded until they're finished. Deadlines are firm, unless you have completed community service as already outlined. The prime directive, my prime directive, what's the big thing that's important to me, is it fair to all concerned? Before you ask that your teacher does something for you, ask yourself if it's fair to all concerned. If it is fair to the other students, then ask yourself that. Is it fair to the taxpayers? You know, these people have paid over $150,000 for you to go to school at no cost to you. So I have to ask myself, is what you're asking fair to the taxpayers? Is it fair to you? Is it fair to your instructor? That is it fair to me? Double duty. Hey, if you can make a project that you're working for in this class also earn for you credit in another class, or even earn for you money, I salute you. Being helpful. You know, being helpful is just expected, and it's a grade in this class. So, being helpful is what you should strive to do in this class. If I, your instructor, fail to see that you have been helpful and you don't earn that grade, speak up for yourself, advocate for yourself, tell me. Better yet, send me a well-written email that explains to me how you have been helpful. It is expected that you will both write and speak well in this class. There is a time and a place for shortcuts, but not in a class about storytelling. Unless, of course, you're quoting somebody. So, what next? Well, you need to take the sheet of paper that you were given, print your full name on it, tell me the date, get your folks or your guardians to print their name and sign their signature that they've at least had a chance to take a look at this, and give me their phone number, and give me an email address that's good for them. Then you bring it back and, hey, poofta, it's a grade. There is no shortage of stories that need to be told, and that's just what we're here to do. This is a storytelling class, and this is a way that we're going to learn all kinds of ways to tell stories.